all, Dixie here. Today I'd like to talk to you about the Camino de Santiago, more specifically the French Way. As many of you know, I'll be hiking the Camino very soon with my little sister Montana. I am 33, she is 19, I am the oldest, she is the youngest, and I'm really excited for us to take this trip together. But I know a lot of you may not be familiar with the Camino, so today I wanted to do a frequently asked questions style video to kind of help answer some of the questions I've been seeing popping up in the comments and on other platforms on social media. Now, I am certainly no expert, but just as I've been researching and preparing to go, I've looked some of these questions up myself because I also wondered these things. And these are the answers that I've kind of landed upon. Now, when I get there and I get done with the experience, of course, I will be happy to come back and share with y'all what I've learned. First off, you might have heard of the Camino, if not before, then after the movie The Way came out. This movie has helped popularize the Camino, kind of the way Wild did for the PCT and A Walk in the Woods did for the Appalachian Trail. For those of you who are familiar with the Camino, you might be surprised that I decided to take this path or this trail instead of another wilderness trail like one of the Triple Crown trails, AT, PCT, and CDT, like I've already done. But my sister Montana isn't into backpacking per se, but I knew that she would be up for the more cultural experience. And for myself, I just wanted something a little bit different. I've spent a year and a half in the wilderness, digging holes and going to the bathroom in them. And I thought as a treat to myself, you know, treat yourself, that it would be pretty cool to go on something like the Camino that is more of a cultural experience than a wilderness experience. So I'm pretty excited for that. But my wilderness days are not over. I just wanted to try something a little different after completing the Triple Crown. The first question I'd like to address is, how do you choose what route to take? When I first started hearing about the Camino, I would hear people say, I'm gonna hike the Camino. And then I would hear somebody who was probably more familiar with it say something like, well, which one? Kind of, you know, annoyed like, because it seems that when people say the Camino de Santiago, they don't realize that there are many, many, many Caminos in Europe. So the one that my sister and I have decided to do is termed the French Way. Some of the other popular ones are the Portuguese Way, the Northern Way, the Camino Primitivo, and the English Way. But those aren't even the only Caminos in Europe. So that goes back to the question of how do we choose exactly which route we wanted to take? Well, the most popular of the Caminos is the French Way. And from what I hear, it's not the oldest path, but the most traditional Camino experience that you can get. We had our eye on the Northern Way or the Del Norte. It's more of a coastal walk. I heard that it's very beautiful, but there tend to be less people on that path. But since we're new to this and we're going to a different country, I just figured getting the most traditional or taking the most popular route might be good for us starting out. And then, hey, we can always go do another one. Next, how long is it? Well, of course, the different routes are different lengths, but the French Way that I'm doing is about 500 miles and it spans from, now I'm going to totally butcher the name, but I believe it's something like Saint Jean Pied de Port. I do not speak French, but that's in France where that starts. To me, from Alabama, it looks like Saint Jean Pied de Port, but I know that's super cringy. I feel like I do a disservice trying to pronounce it the proper way though, so hopefully this is going to be one of the things that I learn while I'm over there, is to kind of recognize how things are actually pronounced the proper way in that country, because I know that it's not Saint Jean Pied de Port. Anyway, it starts there in France, then passes over the Pyrenees, down to Pamplona, across the plains, and into the hills of northwest Spain. It officially ends at Santiago de Compostela, and that's where the shrine of the apostle Saint James the Great is rumored to be buried, or his remains are there. While the French Way officially ends at Compostela, a lot of pilgrims, which is the term for folks walking this path, end up continuing on to Fisterra or Murcia, which is at the Atlantic Ocean, which is termed the foot of the Atlantic. But what's interesting is traditionally it wasn't a certain length, so it wasn't just 500 miles from the starting point to a certain ending point. In fact, a lot of people in Europe would just start out their front door and then walk to the path from wherever they lived, probably because back then it didn't make sense to spend money on travel if you were going out on this walking pilgrimage anyway. So I've mentioned that this is more of a cultural or even maybe a religious experience. So that led me to wonder, well, how old exactly is this pilgrimage? It actually dates back to the Middle Ages and was highly traveled back then. Then the Black Death, Protestant Reformation, and political unrest kind of led to the decline of folks going out on this pilgrimage. By the 1980s, only a few hundred pilgrims were registering at the pilgrim's office each year. And then in 1987, the Council of Europe declared it the first European cultural route. And ever since then, the popularity has continued to increase and more pilgrims come to walk the Camino each year. So that leads to the next question of, well, how many folks walk it each year? In 2016, there were 278,000 people who received their Compostela certificate. Now, this doesn't mean that 278,000 people walked the entire path of one of the Camino pathways. It means that those people walked at least 100 kilometers, which is about 62 miles, or biked 200 kilometers. So there are folks who walk it, there are some folks who bike it, but to receive the Compostela certificate there at Santiago de Compostela, you have to have done at least 100 kilometers. So I would say most of those people probably just do that amount to get the certificate instead of the whole pathway, but still, that's a whole lot of folks going through there each year. And 176,000 of those pilgrims were on the French Way. The next question is, what's up with the shell? From what I understand, the scallop shell represents the Camino in the way that the white blaze, for example, represents the Appalachian Trail. That's kind of the symbol to let you know, hey, go this way. And it's also something that people carry with them. And it kind of indicates to people, hey, I'm a pilgrim who is walking the Camino. From what I've read, the scallop shell was more of a token of completion back in the medieval times. And there are several stories as to how the scallop shell became the symbol of the Camino. But I've heard that it was probably just people wanted to take a souvenir with them when they left. So for whatever reason though, it is kind of the symbol of the Camino. I've heard that you can purchase a shell to carry with you, but that I guess kind of like a trail name, it's more special potentially if somebody gives it to you or if you find it along the way. So I think that's probably what Montana and I will do when we get there, is just happen upon one or be gifted one. Is the Camino strictly a religious experience? The answer to that is no. It can be many things for many different people. For some, it's definitely a religious experience. For others, more of a cultural experience. In fact, at the end, when you receive your Compostela certificate, that's actually the more religious certificate of completion. But they also have a certificate of welcome for people who are not doing it for religious or more spiritual reasons, but for more of a cultural experience or for some other reason. Regardless, I've heard that you get a passport at the beginning from the pilgrim's office and then get stamps along the way. And that's more or less your credentials to show at the end to get either your certificate of Compostela or your certificate of welcome. Where do you sleep? This is something that I was definitely interested to know. I had heard that if you hike the Camino that you get to sleep in town every night, and I think for some routes that's true and others there might be more options for camping. For the French Way, I will be staying in albergues, which are more or less, from what I understand, hostels. I think on average, from what I've heard, they run anywhere from 6 to 17 euros per night. Some of them will include meals like dinner and breakfast. And then there are some more donation-based places to stay along the way. And you can even get as fancy as to stay in hotels or more private lodging along the way. But for us, we'll probably be taking the more budget-friendly options. How long does it take? On average, it takes folks about 35 days to complete the French Way. Now, it will probably take us a little bit longer because I'm sure Montana and I will really enjoy a couple of zeros along the way, and we're allowing ourselves a 2-month visit to Europe. We're actually gonna start in Paris, check that out for a few days, ride a train to the beginning point, and then walk if we have time when we finish, then we'd like to go visit Italy if possible. So that's kind of our plan since we're already going to be over there. So we're really going to stretch this thing out and allow ourselves 2 months, but I've heard it takes about 35 days. Do you need a visa? Being from the US, I have up to 90 days to visit in Europe before I have to worry about any kind of visa. So with us having that 2 month time period, we'll be good. How much does it cost to hike the Camino? From what I've read, it's about 35 euros per day on average. Now, I'm sure that you could do it more on the cheap, and I'm sure that you could do it a little more in luxury, just like any other trail that you go out and hike or any other adventure that you take. So that's from what I understand the average. So if you do it in 35 days, then that would be 1,225 euro plus the cost of your flight, plus the cost of your gear. And for you folks in the US, that's about $1,344. What do you eat? Well, they have stores over in Spain where you can purchase food and carry with you as you walk. My friend Deanna has actually done the French Way twice and took her two sons the second time, did it solo the first time. She said that sometimes they would buy things like a loaf of bread and make sandwiches for a couple of days, or some of the places that you stay have kitchen areas that you can cook in. And then of course there are restaurants and things along the way. So you're not having to carry a ton of food in a food bag on your back, because you will pass through some sort of town or civilization at least once a day. What about insurance? So on the Appalachian Trail, the Pacific Crest Trail, and the Continental Divide Trail, I did not carry insurance. I just figured if I ended up injured, I would pay it as I went. I know that that's not the most wise decision, and I accept that, and I accepted, you know, the consequences of that situation. But being in a different country, I'm gonna be a little bit more cautious, and especially the kicker was having my little sister with me. If I get hurt and I'm an idiot and it's inconvenient, then that's my own fault. But if my sister's hurt and I'm like, hey, we gotta get on a plane and get back home before this can be treated, I'm not gonna put her in that situation. So I ended up going through World Nomads, and for the 2 months that we'll be gone and the three different countries that we'll hopefully visit, it's gonna cost us together about $450 for the whole shebang in travel insurance. What are you looking forward to the most? Well, I'm really looking forward to a different culture, meeting people from all over the world, trying different foods, hearing different words in a different language, and just the entire experience. And I think what makes it most special is that I get to share this with my little sister. And I don't have children of my own. As I mentioned before, I'm 33 and she's 19. My siblings are much younger than I am. So because I don't have my own children, yes, I am still their sister, but they feel more like children to me. And you always want better for your children. I didn't get my passport and get to cross into another country until I was 30. And so knowing that my sister is getting to get out of Alabama and see something different, something new, and that there's a whole world out there at 19 is just very special to me. And I'm happy that I get to drag her along for this experience. So while I know that this isn't going to be anything like the other trails that I've hiked before, I still think that it's gonna be something very special. And I'm also looking forward to capturing the experience and getting to share it with other folks. I know that there are a lot of people who aren't physically capable of doing something like the AT, PCT, or CDT, but I do know that some of those people might be able to do something like the Camino, where you're not having to carry quite as much weight on your back every day and not carry as much weight in the way of food and water. So maybe this will encourage some of y'all who say you can't get out and do those longer trails to do something like the Camino and still go on an amazing adventure. At least, I hope it's gonna be amazing. All right, y'all, well, that is all I have for you today as far as questions and answers go about the Camino de Santiago, more specifically the French Way. If you feel like I've missed a question that I should have answered, feel free to leave that in the comments and I'll answer it to the best of my ability, or I'll make something up. I'm just kidding. Of course, I'm not an expert, but I can tell you what I know before I go do it and what I've researched anyway. As far as gear goes, be looking out for that next week. I'll be sharing the gear list that I'm taking with me. It will be, of course, different than the other trails I've done, but I'm testing out a new piece of equipment that I'm pretty excited to try out. Hopefully it goes well. But thank y'all so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe before you go if you want to follow us on this Camino adventure, and we will see y'all next time.